Next minutes we'll be having a very quick review of C4D negative antibody mediated rejection. We'll be covering the pathogenesis of complement mediated injury, the evidence we have for existence of a C4D negative antibody mediated rejection, the possible explanation for this negativity, and the differences in outcomes. Well, as you all know, antibody mediated rejection is detrimental to graft outcomes in resensitized individuals and those with de novo donor specific antibodies. The BAMF criteria, the updated BAMF criteria, has taken into account that antibody-mediated rejection is heterogeneous. You have the subclinical, you have the chronic, you have the C4D negative, and you have the antibody-mediated vascular rejection. So our sequence for the complement-mediated injury starts with the donor-specific antibody binding to the HLA antigen on the endothelium, activating C1 complex and leading to a cascade of reactions, ending with the formation of the membrane attacking complex, which initiates a lysis and injury. And the activation of the donor-specific antibodies to C1 complex actually depends on the antibody strength, the epitope density, the isotype of the antibody. For example, IgG1 and IgG3 have higher affinity to C1 complex. And so where does the C4D come from? It actually comes from the cleavage of a C4B to a smaller molecule C4C and C4D. And C4D is biologically inactive. It binds covalently to endothelial cells, leading to us calling it the footprint of antibody-mediated rejection. And this has led the BAMF in 2003 and 2007 to include it as an essential criteria for diagnosis of antibody-mediated rejection. So is this the end of story? I wish I only have 6 minutes. But the problems with C4D staining has arisen. There are different staining techniques, different cutoff values. For example, on a paraffin section, focal staining is considered positive. On a frozen section, focal staining is probable antibody-mediated rejection. You depend on the density of the peritubular capillaries. There are concerns it can wax and wane over time. In ABO-incompatible graft, you have C4D staining, which is actually a sign of tolerance and not a sign of rejection. And we all know that C4D is specific, but how sensitive is it? Is it? In 2009, the study has found that endothelial gene expression, which is simply speaking a change in gene expression in endothelial cells when exposed to stress, actually does correlate very well with antibody-mediated rejection. But what the study also has found that in over 50% of biopsies with chronic antibody-mediated rejection, circulating donor-specific antibodies and high levels of endothelial gene expression were C4D negative. In other words, C4D has failed to identify over 50% of biopsies with chronic antibody-mediated rejection. Another study of 54 resensitized individuals, protocol biopsies taking at 3 months, these patients had finding of antibody-mediated rejection subclinical with no C4D staining. And when following these patients, the protocol biopsies at 1 year, we found that there was evidence of chronic four-fold increase in risk of chronic antibody-mediated rejection in these patients. So how can this be? Well, there is always the Fc receptor of the donor-specific antibody that can activate natural killer cells and lead to a complement-free cell-mediated injury, which is free from complement activation. So these are the possible explanations we have for C4D negativity. It is the inability of this donor-specific antibody subclass to fix complement. It is the Fc-mediated graft injury. It is the methodological issues we have with C4D staining. It is the fluctuation of the C4D deposition according to donor-specific antibody titch, alteration in endothelial HLA regulation, and complement clearance. So this has led the BAMF in 2007 actually to include other things than C4D staining as essential for the diagnosis of antibody-mediated rejection. For example, you have the moderate microvascular inflammation and you have increased gene expression, which can substitute for C4D positivity. But also acknowledging C4D specificity for antibody-mediated rejection, it could also substitute for donor-specific antibody testing, although they really recommend that you test thoroughly for donor-specific antibodies. So this study in 2016 had studied the differences in outcome between C4D positive and negative rejections. There were no differences in phenotypes of the patients. It has found that C4D positive antibody-mediated rejection is more common, tends to present earlier, tends to have a clinical presentation with elevated serum creatinine and so on, and tends to have a more detrimental effect on the graft outcome. Although this was not statistically significant, both C4D positive and negative had a detrimental effects on graft outcome. So, to sum it up, C4D positive antibody mediated rejection tends to present earlier, and C4D negative had a later presentation. There was more clinical evidence with C4D positivity and less clinical evidence when you have C4D negative antibody mediated rejection. And there was a small study done over two patients, two cases with C4D negative antibody mediated rejection, where they used colizumab or anti-C5 complement, anti-complement treatment that was not effective in this case. Furthermore, augmenting the thought that there might be a complement-free injury in these patients with C4D negative antibody-mediated rejection too. So to sum it up,